Hello and welcome to Podcasts with Pitchers, Episode 4. This was the first Dirty Crabber cassette released in 1991. This was the second Dirty Crabber cassette released in 1992. This was the Dirty Crabber CD 93. My brother Chad came up with the idea for the black background. Here we are in the studio at Crystal Clear Studios. This is my sculptor on the right, John Catho Christensen in England. That's Jason Mewes. Do you remember Jay and Silent Bob? This is J.R. Steiner. This is the guy who created our Kill Tony t-shirt. This is Kimberly Congdon with me. I was in my street clothes in a rare visit to the Comedy Store. Here I am on Doug Benson's Getting Doug with High. Look, I'm performing a magic trick there. See the fire? That's Gabe, the magic guy. This is Gabe time after the show. Okay, here's the closer. I accidentally tripped Kira Sedgwick in this episode, and now I have 1 degree separation with Kevin Bacon. This is an episode of Monk. Monk, look at me in the background. There I am, Jenny Sullivan on the far left. I was in Get 'Em to the Greek with her, too. This is the movie The Vatican Tapes. Came out in 2015. I'm on the left. Okay, this was my video, Iron Patriot Rock Roller, released in 2015. Okay, I sent it out all over the internet. That was a response I got. This guy nominated me for Video of the Year at the Independent Music Awards. Okay, this was a TV movie called Citizen Jane, Meatloaf, Ally Sheedy. He was a detective making her realize that her boyfriend killed her aunt. Okay, here we go, Boston Legal. I know I already showed you guys a shot from this, but there's another angle there with the briefcase walking by. Okay, this was on top of a tall building in downtown Los Angeles. That's Rob Lowe. This is Brothers and Sisters. Miserable day. Okay, this is, for the last 3.5 years, I've been doing Uber. That's UCLA. I dropped off a guy. Okay, this was a Geico commercial I was seen in 2017, the Running of the Bulls. The set of Bold and Beautiful. This is a movie, Crazy Stupid Love. Steve Carell's character was a guy going through a divorce, trying to rediscover his manhood. 2011. I'm up there on the left side, right on the aisle. Okay, this was a movie, 2012, Supernova. I'm pretending a supernova is hitting the earth at this moment. Look at how much I'm getting into it. Okay, Wish I Was Here, Zach Braff. He funded that movie on Kickstarter. Okay, here you go. The Masters of Sex, the story of Masters and Johnson. Lizzie Kaplan on the right. Okay, Better Off Ted. This was a short-lived TV series. I'm in the cubicle back there. I'm trying to look busy. Look, I even turn around, just killing time. That was a boring day. Okay, that was my old Iron Man suit. Look at my big bubble butt. You could see me from behind. Okay, in June of 2010, Bumblebee, Catwoman, Zorro, and Edward Scissorhands got arrested. And then we found out we were banned. We were banned all the way till November of 2010. We couldn't work on the boulevard for tips. Here are some characters down at City Hall. They went down and protested. Okay, this is the Iron Patriot in Iron Man 3. They changed it up. It comes from the Green Goblin in the comic books. This is the real story. It's Norman Osborn. He steals Iron Man's suit and paints it red, white, and blue. He's really a villain. He isn't a hero like Don Cheadle became in Iron Man 3. Okay, there I am on the boulevard posing, taking pictures with people. Okay, here's Dexter. This was down in Long Beach. We did this. And I'm holding the big, heavy plate of meat, you know. I didn't complain. It was straining my back. Okay, there's Michael C. Hall. I first saw him in 6 Feet Under. Okay, that's Ariel Winter. This was one of the last episodes of ER. You see me driving the car right there. She went on to star in Modern Family. To the left right here of Lea Michele and Glee. Okay, this was Flash Forward. This was a very ambitious show. It only made it one season. But look, I had to fall over and over. This wasn't easy to do. And then look at the great effect they have on this guy falling into the glass here. That was amazing. Okay, this was a special episode of Hannah Montana. It was one of the last ones. It aired in 2011. You see Vicki Lawrence coming down the stairs here. I was a huge fan of the Carol Burnett show, so I loved this moment. You know, I didn't get to talk to her, though, because, you know, everybody's working. You just don't get a chance. And then you got Miley Cyrus coming up right here. I was impressed with her. This was right before she launched into pop stardom. That's Billy Ray Cyrus, her father on the right. I remember seeing him in that David Lynch film, Mulholland Drive, in 2001. That was an epic movie. So that was a cool day all the way around. And here's Miley. She's dreaming about her future's pop stardom. Okay, this is a TV series, My Boys, about a sports columnist woman in Chicago. Okay, look at the green shirt. That's me in Greek again. Okay, John Starr, look on the right. He was in Welcome Back, Kotter as an extra. And here he is down here on the bottom on the right on Parks and Recreation. That was the last day. Okay, thanks for watching Podcast with Pitcher.